Hi, my name is Roger. In this video, I'm going to show you a program. But first of all, the result of that program, or possible result, is this image here. I don't use Inkscape or GIMP to design this stuff. I use HTML and CSS to design stuff like this. It's real easy and fast, and you don't have to learn how to design. So this here is that little utility. It's called WebText. What does it do? Very simple. You open up a text file. This here is a text file that holds the code. It's a simple text file, nothing else. This is the complete HTML and CSS document of that image that you saw. So that's done real quickly and easy, instead of learning to design in Inkscape or GIMP. You can use the built-in HTML viewer, but it uses an old rendering engine and it can't show you this kind of gradient. It simply cannot. That's why I have here in my menu a launch button. So this here can be saved as a text file. You can open an HTML file. I don't have it yet. Oh, I do have it. So let's open it up. It's read in like a text file. You can save it. I'm not going to save this one as a color wheel. Let's call this one mask, just to show you how it works. So now I press my launch button and it will launch the last saved HTML file. Here you have that HTML file, mask. This is the image, of course. So this is the utility you need to write in order to do the design real quickly. You can change these colors if you want to. You can add colors to it and get even a nicer image. So let's get started with this here. This is the window. This is a text area. That's all there is to it. I've a menu on the left side here. The open event of the text area is text size is 15. I've done that so you can read it a little bit better. Here we have a variable called save HTML file as string. We're going to need this for storing our file path to launch that HTML file. That's why you need this variable. Then we have F as a folder item. Then we go to the file type. Of course, we need one for text. And we're going to need one for HTML. You can click this button and look for them. Then we will move on to the clear. This here is clearing out your text area. This here is the variable that holds the path to your last saved HTML file. So when you clear something, you clear that one or empty it as well. Then the open text. This here is an open dialog, of course, you know that. You know this stuff already, so I'm not going to walk you through it. I'm going to show you the difference between opening an HTML and text file. This is the difference between those two files. Here we have the opening filter set to text, and the open HTML button has this one. That's all the difference there is. And of course, I name my variables, my local variables, I name them differently, but you don't even have to. That's all the difference there is. So with the saving part, here you have file type 1.txt, because we're going to save a text file. Now, this is something you've already seen before. If you don't, well, simply type it or go to the video where I talk about input streams and output streams and how you can read and write files. Here you have the HTML file. That's all the difference there is. You can use exactly the same code except this one here, this line here. This is save HTML file, that's the variable we've declared, is equal to f.nativepath. Nativepath is this path over here. That's all of this. That's your native path. And that's the one that you need in order to make this button work. To launch that file, you need to say F is equal to get folder item, and then the variable name where you store that complete path in. So save HTML file and then f.launch. And then you get this here. When you press launch, it simply launches the mask again, like I've done here. And here I've launched this one. So that's how it works. This image, we do need that one. So I'm going to show you real quickly how you can get that image off of here. Right click mouse. Now this is all Dutch. It says here, the highlighted line, take a screenshot. You select that one, you get this in Mozilla Firefox. I don't know in other web browsers, I only use Mozilla. You move your mouse over your image. It automatically selects this whole area. Left mouse click only once, and then click download and you have the image. In the next video, we're going to build a color picker with this. So build this little utility. It's very easy and you can have a lot of joy of it.